The National Security Council is calling on a group to abandon its planned civilian mission to Ayung in Seoul, which has been the flashpoint of maritime tensions between the Philippines and China. The Atento coalition earlier announced it will bring supplies to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre. Well, joining us now to talk about this is the Assistant Director General of the National Security Council, Jonathan Malaya, ADG. Malaya, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me, Carmina.
All right. Now, before we talk about the Christmas convoy, President Marcos meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping on the sidelines of the APEC summit. And let me quote the president here when they met or after. The president said that, "I don't think anybody wants to go to war." He also said that we tried to come up with mechanisms to lower tensions in the South China Sea. Going back here at home, ADG, how might this meeting and this thinking of mechanisms affect the current policies that the government has regarding the West Philippine Sea?
Well, I think what the president said during that meeting with the president of China is simply a reiteration of our current policy that our maritime tensions or territorial dispute with China is not the end all and be all of the Philippine-China relationship. It is a vibrant relationship across many different areas. No, there are very robust diplomatic exchanges. There is a very strong trade and economic relationship between the Philippines and China. And this territorial dispute should not be the end all and be all of that relationship.
Mm. Enter the Christmas convoy. Two aspects here. You've got security and you've got the sentiment of the people wanting to push through with this convoy. Let's focus on sentiment first. How can you curtail the sentiment or the manifestation of the sentiment of the people by saying you don't approve of this, you're thumbing down this planned Christmas convoy, ADG?
No, it would be irresponsible for the National Security Council to support this kind of activity. You know, Carmina, we received a letter from them last week where in that letter they asked for our support. Now, as I said in our statement yesterday, given the heightened tensions between the Philippines and China, and given that in the past Aurora missions, the entire world knows what has happened with our civilian supply ships supported by Philippine Coast Guard ships. Given the ramming incidents that has happened, the laser incidents, and the many other provocative and coercive actions taken by China, it would be ill-advised for them to move forward with this. Mm-hmm. And no, Carmina, we're not actually closing the door to a similar event in the future. But at this time of heightened tensions between the Philippines and China, it is our respectful suggestion to them if they can just do the Christmas convoy to the other Philippine-occupied features, not just Ayungin. Remember, there are 8 other Philippine-occupied features in the West Philippine Sea.
Mm. How might this, if it does push through, ADG, how might this put the government in a precarious position? Because can you give them assistance while they go there? And if you do, how might this be misread as something as a government exercise and not a civilian exercise?
Exactly, Carmina. You make a very good point. You read my mind. The civilian convoy places the Philippines in a very difficult position, precisely because China, I would presume, would never believe that this is not a government sanctioned operation or mission. And given the heightened tensions between the Philippines and China over the Ayungin Shoal, it would be best, no, if the coalition behind this planned Christmas convoy, Atin Ito, would just bring Christmas cheer or holiday cheer to Philippine troops in Pag-asa, in Lawak, in Parola, no, and you know, there are also civilian communities and Philippine troops in this area, and they also deserve a Christmas cheer. Mm. No, why not focus their attention to these features, where we don't have the same heightened tensions as opposed to a union.
Conversely, though, China has been able to do exactly what they want to do without any regard for what we may think. Why should we sort of think about what they might think?
I didn't say that we should not think about what they may think, you know? In fact, we continue to assert our sovereignty, sovereign rights, and jurisdiction of the entire West Philippine Sea, notwithstanding the coercive, the blocking, and the other dangerous maneuvers done to the Philippines by Chinese vessels. We continue to assert, but my position, the position of the National Security Council at this time is that given the heightened tensions between our two nations, it would be ill-advised to undertake that civilian Christmas convoy at this time.
You know, we've talked at length about this topic for many occasions now, and I think it was during our last conversation when we talked about, you know, owning, bringing this movement to the Filipino people. And that is the goal, for the Filipino people to really take this as their own issue, as their own movement. And that's exactly what's happening now. This Christmas convoy, wouldn't you consider that as the truest manifestation of the sentiment and of this movement that they now own, and yet your opposition to it, not this time? So how do you explain that to them?
Carmina, our opposition to it, no, is because of the security aspect. If there were no tensions between the Philippines and China, if we can guarantee the security of the convoy, then there would be no problem insofar as the National Security Council is concerned. Mm. But given that the world has seen the problems faced by our Coast Guard and by our civilian contracted supply vessels, no, it would be irresponsible for the National Security Council to support this at this time. If the objective, Carmina, well, they have explained to us that the objective is two things. Number one is to bring Christmas cheer. No, and as I said already, why are the Ayungin personnel being given some sort of special arrangement? No, our other personnel in the eight other occupied features also deserve Christmas cheer. No.
And what if they do every occupied territory?
That's why we are open to dialogue with them. We can talk to them about this, no? If they wish to have some sort of escort, a government escort, then we can arrange that, no? And number two, if the objective is to bring goodies, no? Christmas goodies to our troops in Ayungin Shoal, these Christmas goodies can be brought to the Philippine Coast Guard or to the Philippine Navy, AFP's Western Command, and we will gladly bring these Christmas goodies to Ayungin Shoal to BRP Sierra Madre, during the regular routine and resupply mission. Mm. No?
I am assuming that the President knows about this planned convoy. What did he have to say about it?
Well, I would presuppose, because as far as I know, the National Security Advisor has briefed the President about this. And as relayed to me by the National Security Advisor, the position of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea, no, is to discourage the convoy to Ayungin and to encourage them instead to bring the Christmas goodies to the other Philippine occupied features, no, to also bring attention to the other troops in other Philippine occupied features. And the other thing that they've been saying, the Atin Ito Coalition, is that they would also like to bring Christmas cheer and supplies to these fishermen in the West Philippine Sea, no, to the fishing communities there. By going to the other features in the West Philippine Sea, they are able to bring Christmas cheer to more people, because by going to the other features, they will be visiting a greater part of the West Philippine Sea than by focusing attention only to ayong isyo.
ADG, you've been very, very measured in your statements this morning. You're saying it's an opposition, yes, but it's you're also saying you're just discouraging. Never did you once say that you're imposing your template and what you believe should be done on this group. But what if they persist? And what if they push through? What's going to happen next?
Well, you know, Carmina, they requested for escorts from the government, no, in particular from the Philippine Coast Guard. Given the opposition of the National Security Council, that cannot be given. So if they persist on doing this, they will have to do it on their own. Number two, this is a commissioned vessel of the government. The BRP Sierra Madre is a commissioned vessel of the Philippine Navy. No one can just dock beside a Philippine Navy commissioned vessel without authority from the government, in particular the Armed Forces of the Philippines. So again, there are also permits that have to be secured by their group. No, so rather than complicate the situation, we are open to dialogue with them. We are willing to sit down at the earliest possible opportunity to discuss. Because if their purpose is to bring holiday cheer, as I said, we can bring the goodies to BRP Sierra Madre at any given time that they can give it to us.
Is part of the scenario like meeting halfway? Like they push through with a convoy, but only up to a certain point, and then government resources or government personnel can pick up the convoy, the goods from them, and bring it to BRP
yes.
Sierra Madre. Is that something that's possible?
Yes, that's possible. But insofar as them utilizing their own boats going to the BRP Sierra Madre is concerned, I don't think that is possible at this time. However, if we can have some sort of a turnover ceremony somewhere, no, mm-hmm. in Palawan perhaps, or even in Manila, where they turn over the goodies, mm-hmm. no, the donated stuff to the Philippine Coast Guard or to the Philippine Navy, and we will ensure that these are brought to BRP Sierra Madre.
All right. Assistant Director General of the National Security Council, Jonathan Malaya, thank you for joining us this noon. Really appreciate you having this conversation with us. Thanks again.
Thank you for having me.